Today I'm talking about the advantages of gaming. Gaming is basically the running of applications, electronic applications, and which is known as electronic games, especially on machines designed for such programs. Gaming can be done in various like machines and consoles, like Xbox or like PlayStation, even computers and like people see that video games are addictive and unhealthy, but I think people are being hypocritical and only focusing and criticizing about the disadvantages of gaming. Gaming has many advantages, like it has a new way of learning and teaching. Almost all children have access to video games as they study in school. There are many educational institutions nowadays that use video games, like New York University, which has been using gaming as a teaching methodology. Many schools have started using this method, as researchers have proved that this way of teaching is fun for students, as they won't get bored and like their concentration won't like fade away. This approach works best in teaching these students to improve their academic skills. There are many video games that were specially made to develop their creative thinking skills. According to Chef L. Diwani, gaming is a much efficient way of learning than studying and reading. The gaming also improves hand and eye coordination. Expert authors like Nick Samoski and Jordan Miller agree that people who play video games and computers have better hand and eye coordination than other people. Gamers have to move at great deal of speed and punch various buttons at like split seconds, which makes the hand and eye coordination better. This can be helpful with children and adults, as well as in applying the skill in other activities that require better hand and eye coordination. Gaming also cures some health disorders. There are many medical institutions that utilize computer games and other types of games as a form of physiotherapy. A group of Australian physicians also said that gaming heals hand muscle problems, as the gamer has to press different buttons in split seconds and also decreases the chance of paralysis. This kind of game help people recover fast from physical injuries and help them improve their motor and coordination skills as well. They also say that distraction is the best natural remedy for pain and what other things loaded with so much fun as games. Gaming also boosts imagination power. In the world of computer games, the possibilities are endless. Video gaming is packed with a lot of adventure that forces your mind to think in a completely new and different way. You'll be amazed to know how far your imagination can take you. Me myself have experienced this, because I started playing games at the age of 9, and I have improved a lot in creative writing and art, which is the field where you need imagination. Gaming also improves problem solving skills. According to researcher Christine Tucker, playing some type of games improves your problem-solving skills. This type of game, some type of game requires problem-solving skills. Suppose you are the heroine of your own game, so you should have a good decision-making skill. Most games inspire players to strive and reach more difficult levels, presenting challenges at every stage. Gaming also sharpens your reflexes. Gaming sharpens your reflexes amazingly, as in most of the games, you must act and push buttons and think really fast, which increases our reflexes, which is very useful. It helps on instant reaction against someone's attack, etc. This also, I have also experienced in my own life, as I was really bad at table tennis, so after I started playing games, I really improved in it. Gaming also increases stress and tension. As many surveys and researches by students from university in Sweden has proved that gaming not only passes your time and increases your concentration power, but also gets rid of all the stress and tension in your life. I think this is true because when I'm stressed, I play games, which helps me reduce my stress. People still may argue about gaming as they think like they only give these advantages and not really help in our life, but some people game and design games for building a living for themselves. Gaming and designing game has been a famous profession amongst people nowadays. Game designers like Will Wright, who designed SimCity, The Sims, Toru Iwatani, who designed the world famous game Pac-Man, and Jeffrey Kaplan, who designed Warcraft, are world famous, rich and successful game designers. These games that they made are praised by people from different ages all around the world, which has earned a huge amount of money, respect, and as well as popularity. People has also made gaming as their career. Like they game and in different tournaments and like events, which they can make money out of. So I would like to present video.
Welcome to Digital Journal Television. I'm David Silver.
And I'm Chris Hoff. Kids these days, they're playing more and more video games. Big surprise, right? Well, we've actually got a surprise for you. A recent study came out that shows 99% of boys and 94% of girls in the U.S. are now playing video games. It's an enormous amount, but...
Surprised you, Dave? Not really, but there's some big shockers in this landmark report from the Pew Internet and American Life Project. Critics, it's not just about violence. Stay tuned to find out more.
There's benefits?
The stigma of loner games goes up in smoke with this new study. Researchers found 65% of kids play video games with friends in the room. And when playing online, 70% of kids play with people they know in real life.
And here's an interesting stat, especially for those worried about the influence of violence in video games. Close to two-thirds of kids notice people being mean or aggressive while playing games. But there's good news. Three-quarters of teens noticed another player stepping in to ask the aggressor to stop at least some of the time.
The Pew study also looked at games kids play frequently, which could offer some insight into what attracts you to chilling out in front of a console. The five most popular games for American teens are, in order, Guitar Hero, Halo 3, Madden NFL, Solitaire, and Dance Dance Revolution. Looks like it's not all first-person shooters. Kids are stretching out their musical muscle while also going old-school with Solitaire, the strategic card game.
Also, the study found that among parents whose kids play games, 62% of them said games have no influence one way or the other on their kids.
And some more good news for parents. Kids who had civic gaming experience, ones where they helped other gamers or made ethical decisions during a game, were more likely to give money to charity and stay informed on current events compared to gamers who barely had those experiences.
This report would probably be music to the ears of someone like author Steven Johnson, who wrote about the value of video games in his book, Everything Bad is Good for You. Today's games, he argues, have complex worlds, layered storytelling, and force kids to find order and meaning in the world.
True, but we likely won't stop seeing studies explaining the link between violence in video games and violence in real life. like one from the University of Michigan released last year. At least Pew's study offers a close look into how kids play games with each other.
So I would say that don't only think that gaming is unhealthy and antisocial and boring, but gaming has many advantages, and you can game and design games and make a living. Thank you.